All right, welcome to The Explainer. Today we are going to break down a huge idea in economics, something that affects pretty much every business you can think of, from the corner coffee shop to a giant car factory. It's called the law of diminishing returns, and it all boils down to one big question. When does adding more of something actually start to give you less? So, let's kick things off with a little thought experiment. Picture this. You own one single taxi cab, just one. The question is, how many drivers should you hire? What's the magic number? Now, this isn't just some brain teaser, right? This is a real-world problem that business owners have to solve all the time. And the answer, you'll see, is actually super logical. So let's dive in and break it down. Okay, section one, the one taxi problem. Let's really think this through. You've got one taxi, one driver. Well, they can't work 24/7, so you hire a second, then a third. Three drivers, 8-hour shifts, perfect. The cab is always out there making money. But what happens if you hire, say, 10 drivers? Or how about 50? What does that look like? Yeah, pretty soon, you just have total chaos. You'd have drivers lining up, waiting to switch shifts, arguing over who gets the keys next. They'd be spending more time not driving than actually driving. And here's the crazy part. The total amount of money that one taxi brings in would actually start to go down. This little story, it perfectly gets to the heart of the problem. And to really solve it, we need to get a couple of key definitions straight. All right, next up, fixed versus variable inputs. These are kind of like the rules of the game. So first up is what we call a fixed input. The easiest way to think about this is like, it's the box your business operates in. It's the part of your operation that is, for now, totally locked in. You can't just snap your fingers and get more of it. So in our taxi example, what's the fixed input? It's the car. You've only got one. If you're running a farm, it's your plot of land. Or maybe you've got an office space on a 5-year lease. The point is, these are the things that, at least in the short run, you're stuck with. And on the other side of the coin, you've got your variable input. Now, this is the stuff you can control. You can change the amount you use pretty much anytime you want. Back to our taxi, the drivers are the variable input. You can hire more. You can schedule fewer shifts. It's flexible. For a coffee shop, it's things like the coffee beans you buy or how much electricity you're using. These are the dials you can actually turn up or down day to day. Okay, time for the main event, the law of diminishing returns, or what I like to call the tipping point. So we've got our fixed input, the taxi, and our variable input, the drivers. Now we're going to see what happens when you mix them together. This is where the magic and the trouble really begins. So the fancy name for what we saw with our taxi problem is the law of diminishing marginal product. Most people just call it diminishing returns. And listen, the crucial point here is not that adding more is always bad. Not at all. It's that eventually you're going to hit a point where each new person you add contributes a little bit less than the person who came before them. And it's so important to get this. This has nothing to do with the workers themselves. We're assuming every single driver is a fantastic, hardworking employee. The problem isn't the people. The problem is the fixed resource. It's the one taxi. It's too many chefs trying to work in one tiny kitchen. They literally just start getting in each other's way. All right, next section, an orchard in numbers, the proof. So that's the theory, right? But theory is one thing. To really see this baby in action, we've got to look at some actual numbers. So let's leave the taxi behind and head over to a classic example, an apple orchard. So the setup here is super simple. The orchard itself, you know, the land, the trees, that's our fixed input. We can't change that. The workers we hire to pick the apples, that's our variable input. And our whole goal here is to figure out the sweet spot. How many workers do we hire to get the absolute most apples off those trees? Okay, check out this data from our orchard. With one worker, we get 500 kilograms of apples. Not bad. Now, bring in a second worker, and our total jumps up to 1,100 kilograms. So obviously, our total's going up. That's great. But here's the really important question. How much extra did that second worker, just by themselves, add to the pile? To figure that out, we calculate something called the marginal product. It sounds complicated, but it's not. It's just the extra little bit that each new person brings to the table. It's literally just simple subtraction. And what's so cool is seeing what happens when we do this for every single worker we add. And boom, here it is. Let's zero in on that marginal product column. Our first worker brings in 500 kilos. But look at this. The second worker adds even more, 600 kilos. For a moment there, things are actually speeding up. We're in a phase of increasing returns. But then the party's over. The third worker adds less, just 400 kilos. And you can see the trend. The extra amount from each new worker just keeps going down, 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 until we hit worker number 7. And that's where things get wild. Check that out. The 8th worker's marginal product is negative 25 kilograms. Let that sink in. This person didn't just add less than the others. Their presence actually made the total harvest go down. They were getting in the way, maybe knocking over baskets. Whatever it was, they made the entire operation less productive. That is diminishing returns in action. Okay, this brings us to the big payoff. How to maximize output, the decision rule. We've got the concept, we've seen the numbers, so how does an actual business owner use this to make a smart call? So the question is simple. When should the orchard owner stop hiring people? Now, let's be super clear about the goal for right now. We're not thinking about profit yet, we're not paying anyone, we have one single goal, get the absolute maximum number of apples into baskets. So looking at our numbers, where's that peak? Well, the data makes it pretty obvious. If you look at 6 workers, our total product hits its absolute maximum, 2,150 kilograms. That's the top of the mountain. The very next worker, number 7, is the one whose contribution is negative. That's our bright red flashing light. That's the signal that tells us to stop. And that right there is the big rule, the main takeaway. If your goal is to maximize total output, you keep adding workers as long as their marginal product is positive, even if it's just one extra apple. The second their contribution hits 0 or goes negative, you stop. That's the rule. So we've cracked the code for maximizing production, but that leaves us with one last massive question, the one that every real business has to answer. What happens when you actually have to pay these people? Is that 6th worker who only brought in an extra 50 kilos of apples actually worth a full day's salary? Suddenly, the math gets a whole lot more complicated. And that, well, that changes the entire game.
Have you ever added just one more thing to a project and suddenly everything just got worse? Well, today, we're going to dive into that exact moment with the Orange Grove test. It's a really simple story that shows us a powerful truth. Sometimes more is actually less.
You know, it's a question we bump into all the time. When is adding one more ingredient, or one more feature, or one more person actually a bad idea? Stick around, because this explainer is going to give you a super clear way to answer that exact question.
All right, so let's paint a picture here. Imagine an orange grove on a kibbutz, and for this one task, the entire community has come together with one single, very clear objective.
And the mission? It's simple. We're not worried about profits or any other complicated stuff. The only goal is to pick the absolute maximum number of oranges they can. That's it.
So if your goal is just to pick the most oranges, and you've got tons of willing workers, what's the obvious answer? Use all of them, right? Well, as we're about to see, that simple intuition could lead to a surprisingly big mistake.
So, how do we find the perfect number of workers? Well, we need to look at the data. Let's start by just tracking the total output, the total number of oranges picked, as we add workers one by one. Okay, let's look at the numbers. With one worker, they pick 50 oranges. A second worker brings the total to 90. Things are looking good. The total keeps climbing, 120, 140, 150. And then it peaks at 151 with the 6th worker. But then something really weird happens. When the 7th worker joins, the total actually drops to 141. How is that even possible?
To solve this puzzle, we have to change how we're looking at this. Instead of staring at the grand total, let's ask a different question. What does each new worker actually add to the team?
And this brings us to a huge idea in economics that's going to unlock this entire puzzle. We need a way to measure the exact value of adding just one more person to the team.
Economists have a term for this, marginal product. Now, it sounds complicated, but it's just a way of asking how many extra oranges did we get because we added this one specific person. This single measurement is the key to making the right decision.
Now, with this new column, a really clear pattern just jumps out at us. The first worker adds 50 oranges, the second adds 40, the third adds 30. You can see the trend, right? 20, 10, and then the 6th worker adds just one single orange. But look at the 7th worker. Their contribution is negative 10. They're not just adding less, they're actively getting in the way, maybe knocking over baskets and making the entire team less productive. The total goes down. This is a perfect illustration of a fundamental economic principle, the law of diminishing marginal returns. It says that at first, adding more resources gives you big gains, but eventually each new addition contributes less and less until, as we just saw, they can actually hurt your total output.
Now that we understand this whole idea of marginal product, we can go back to our original question and find that sweet spot with absolute confidence.
So what was the absolute maximum number of oranges the team could pick? Our data shows us the peak of the mountain, right there, 151.
So the $1 million, or maybe the 151 orange question is, what was the exact team size that got us to this number? And the data gives us a clear answer, 6. 6 workers is the optimal team size to get the maximum possible output. Not 5, and as we're about to see, most certainly not 7. This side-by-side comparison makes the tipping point crystal clear. The 6th worker, even though they only added one single orange, still made a positive contribution. The total went up. But the 7th worker's contribution was negative. They actively reduced the total output. That right there is the stopping point.
What we've discovered in this orange grove isn't just about picking fruit. It's a universal rule for maximizing output anytime you're adding resources to pretty much anything.
And here's the rule boiled down to 2 simple steps. Step 1. Keep adding resources, whether it's workers, ingredients, or features, as long as their marginal product is positive, even if it's just one orange. Step 2. The moment the marginal product turns negative, you stop. That's your signal that you've gone too far.
And that's the crucial insight. It's a little counterintuitive, but if you want to maximize the total, you have to stop looking at the total. Instead, you have to focus on the margin, the contribution of that very next addition.
And this brings us to a final, pretty provocative question. Our orange grove problem was simple because the only goal was to maximize oranges. But what if this wasn't a kibbutz? What if you had to pay each worker a salary? Suddenly, that 6th worker who only added one orange might not be worth it. That changes everything, doesn't it? Something to think about for next time.